Okay, good day everyone. I'll be sharing to you another lecture that I presented, no, in a webinar before members of JCI Senate Philippines. So this talk happened during the pandemic, and the topic that was assigned to me was estate planning for Filipinos. Of course, the topic was become pressing because we know for a fact that at the height of the pandemic, we have literally millions of people who died or became casualties of this pandemic, and I'm sure thousands of those who died were unprepared on how to distribute, liquidate, or apportion their estate. So in my lecture series, I presented a lot of issues, a lot of considerations that anybody with considerable estate, on how, no, to prepare for that eventuality. As they say, we can evade a lot of issues or concerns, but we cannot evade or escape our debt, yung kamatayan. So I'm just having my preliminaries or introduction, because seconds from now, my lecture will start.
As National President of JCI Senate Philippines, thank you very much for
So let's listen to the presenter.
Online learning session, and we are live on Facebook in Ambagco,
listening now to my topic, estate planning for Filipinos.
JCI Philippines Facebook page, JCI Senate Iloilo Facebook page, JCI Iloilo Facebook pages. And we have like more than 50 people tuning in. All right, let's call on Jomri. Are we ready for next speaker?
Thank you, Coach. Good afternoon once again. So for the next talk about estate planning for Filipinos in this pandemic, our speaker is a graduate of the University of the Philippines College of Law. He is a licensed broker, appraiser, and consultant, and a top notcher in the appraisal and consultancy board exam. He is a speaker in almost all real estate and related topics, and has lectured on many seminars all throughout the country that produces hundreds of world top notchers. To cap his mastery in the real estate field, he passed the environmental planning board exam, thus completing his fifth professional license. For more than 10 years, he has been hosting the Sunday program Doralex, Sedlex at Bombo Radio Jensan, which provides free legal advice and education to the poor and marginalized in the South Central Mindanao region. He was a lecturer at the Mindanao State University College of Law, General Santos City, and currently an online professor for real estate management at the Trinity University of Asia. Our speaker served as the national president last 2018 of the Philippine Association of Real Estate Board Incorporated, or PAREB, the county's oldest and largest association of licensed real estate professionals. Presently, he is serving as the national president of the Philippine Association of Realty Consultants and Specialists Incorporated, or PARCS, the county foremost group of licensed real estate consultants. Let's welcome our resource speaker, Attorney Ray Cartujano, with a round of applause.
Salamat, Jomri, for that introduction. Good afternoon, JCs. No, I'm currently based in General Santos City, no, far south. We're near Indonesia. if you travel to Manila, mas malapit pa yung ano to Indonesia than in ano to in than going to Manila, no? To Hong Kong, no, for instance. So I think most of you are familiar also with the area ng city, no, ng General Santos City, so or the tuna capital of the Philippines, just in case. And in terms of yung population distribution, we have a lot of Ilonggos here, no, and Bisaya. And incidentally, also the place of Senator Manny Pacquiao. So I'm just curious because in the past weeks, I've been invited for a lot of talks. And one of the most in-demand topic is estate planning. So kanina I was able to catch up with the presentation. Another also very important topic. Very in-demand topic, mental illness. Now, it's something that for us in this pandemic, many are really suffering from this type of ailment. But I think the another very big factor right now is yung big topic is about death. Now, let's start my presentation on estate planning. These days, no, a lot of people are consulting with lawyers, no, accountants on how to handle their estate because we have a lot of ano to, that's really something that all of us already aware, no, growing debts amidst us. The most of the vulnerable age group are in the senior years, and these are people like most of you here, guys, no, sa JCs. People who have already established themselves in terms of career, business, profession, and even building your wealth all these years. So just some figures, no, just to put yung discussion natin in perspective. If we analyze the income ano to, distribution in the country right now, and in relation to our topic, more or less, if we base on the income bracket, you have only siguro sabihin natin less than 5%, no, of the Filipinos, or even sabihin natin less than 3% of the Filipinos will be interested in estate planning because super majority are really in the ano to, middle and lower income classes. So if we base solely our discussion on income, then we have a very small percentage of our population, especially if our target really is to, yung conventional wisdom is to minimize income taxes. So that is how yung population natin is being distributed, and that is how the 22 elections will also be decided. It will not be decided by those in the top 5 to 10% of the population, but the lowermost, no, C, D, E classes. So sa atin din sa estate planning, kung ang basis natin is just to ano to, think of wealth distribution at the point of death, then you have a very small percentage of the population. And I think most of you here are qualified dahil based on yung global ano to, global survey, according to Knight Frank, in sa Philippines, for you to be considered already wealthy, you're in the category of $210, $210,000 per annum. So that is only around 10 million pesos. Ganun yung level, and we are very low compared with the other countries. So that is how being wealthy is defined, no, here in the Philippines. And this is also yung target natin for estate planning because these are people usually interested in managing their wealth when the time comes, no, when that critical time will come na ano to, no, magpapahinga tayo. And if we base yung ano to, yung current figures natin, that's really very promising because over the past year and months, no, yung casualties are increasing. And sabi nga ng mga experts, COVID will stay with us, no, hindi lang 1 to 2 years. So it would depend also on yung uncertainty ng vaccination, whether or not vaccination will really prove very effective. So with that as background, no, so makita natin increasing increasing figures on yung death, no? Starting February 2020, as of today, still increasing yung number. And you have also a lot of casualties who are really, kung tingnan natin, no? I have known of people who are really very rich. Despite all their resources, they were not able to survive COVID. So hindi lang talaga assurance na mayaman ka, you'll survive COVID, because this ano to, this virus will really ano to, find their way in our homes. But there's a famous saying that says that life is uncertain but death is certain. So yung kamatayan natin, death is indeed inevitable and often comes as a surprise. For this reason, it is difficult to prepare for the death of a loved one. So widespread to ngayon, makita natin, no, left and right, you have people dying. In fact, kami mismo sa immediate family, entire compound, no, being hit by COVID, including my parents. So better that it's good that they were able to survive. But I have clients also who are not able to survive despite their wealth, no? And at the point of death, nasa hospital na, nagbibilang pa sila ng mga ano to, mga assets nila. Sino yung may utang, dinidikta ni ano to, ni Mr. sa Mrs. yung ano to, sinong singilin. So we have come at that point that anytime, no, that ano to, COVID will hit us, there's no assurance that we'll survive. So with that, siguro just perspective on what is the best definition of estate planning, because I'm sure many of you here are very familiar on what is estate planning. So just to put perspective sa discussion natin on estate planning, so estate planning is the process of accumulation, management, conservation, and transfer of wealth, considering legal, tax, and personal objective. So yung nakikita ko na pinakamagandang definition, no, of estate planning. So you have a lot of considerations. Like ano to, yung sa atin kasi conventional wisdom is makakatipid tayo. Sabi naman ng iba, what's the point of saving on tax if you're dead anyway? So that is one perspective. So just quick lang na ano to na background, or before we go into yung details, no, quick details. So what do you mean by an estate? So an estate is everything you own at death. So this covers bank accounts, investments, real estate, insurance, personal property, etc. So take note what you own at the time of your death. That is yung ano to, yung definition of yung estate. So why do you need to ano to plan? What is the really the necessity of planning for your death or planning for your estate? So you have yung mga common, yung medical care, no, yung life prolonging medical care you wish to receive, and the person to make decisions on your behalf. You want also to specify yung person to make financial decisions on your behalf. Morbid man ito, no? At pinag-uusapan na rin during estate planning, whatever yung funeral at saka burial arrangement you want. Then in case you have minor children, yung guardian, no, na maiiwan. Then who receives your ano to, your property among others. Then you also have a say on how your heirs receive your property. Yung tanong ulit, bakit kailangan talaga magplano? No, pwede namang pabayaan yan, no? You just let the inevitable happen, then let the course of things follow its natural course. So maganda sana ang ganun lang ka-easy, no? Because sabihin natin more than 90% of the Filipinos, sabihin natin siguro 99% of most Filipinos are following that step. No? They'll just let ano to, death takes its natural course, and let the ano to, yung law take its natural course also. But you may consider, no, because knowing you guys, no, as being leaders in your respective organizations, you have also built a career wealth over the years, you may want also to consider, no, na you have ano to, you have a say on how your estate will be distributed, because whether you like it or not, aabutin yung panahon, no, that you want, that you have a say on how you will be cared for and who will receive your property. So without a plan, the law and the judge will decide what happens to you and your property. As they say nga, no, the most expensive part in case of disagreement among heirs will be yung legal fees. Dahil both sides of the ano to parties, you will have to shell out in legal fees over the years. So sabi nga nila, in case of ano to conflict between or among heirs, ang panalo yung mga abogado. So would you like that to happen, no, na mag-aaway yung mga heirs, especially for those of you who have already built, no, a lot of yung siguro personal wealth over the years. So let's start with yung goals. Ano ba yung goals? So for ang conventional ano to, estate planning is yung minimizing estate taxes. So that is yung primary estate plan goal natin. But you may want also other goals rather aside from minimizing estate tax. No? For example, you may want to maintain a certain quality of life for yourself and your heirs. Or yung iba, no, yung dinadaan sa biro, you may want to keep your in-laws out of your business. Or you may also want to leave a legacy to your school. So in estate planning, you need first, no, to know your goals so that you can plan for your estate. And from these goals, no, everything will follow. So tingnan natin, no, mga examples, minimizing estate tax. Let us say that is your target, no. So pwede naman yung advice ng mga accountants natin, no, mga tax experts, yung tax-free exchange where property is transferred to a corporation, then the transferor gains control. So pwede din yan, no? So you may also want, if you're a businessman, so in the event of that certain debt, you may want that your business will run without interruption. You may also choose not to create a will. No, pwede, it's your option. So kasi yung paggawa kasi ng will, dadaan pa ng probate yan, it will take years, no? So possibly na that can be disputed. So early on, while you are still alive, then you may decide, no, to ano to, to ensure that your business will run even, no, even at the point of your death. So yung iba, iniiwasan yung proseso ng probate, no, because it could be very tedious, expensive. So if you have some say on how your estate or your business will be run, better na you plan early. So pwede mo nang i-transfer yung negosyo mo now. Now what are the ano to, briefly lang, what are the estate planning factors, no? So after you have your goals, so kanina na mention natin yung ano to, mga example, yung minimizing taxes, no, gusto mong yung negosyo mo tatakbo smooth, no, depending on yung, if you're into business, no, you want certain members of your family not to be included or yung mga in-laws mo, so dapat strategize mo yan early, no, because kung hindi mo na strategize yan early, then baka nga mag-aaway, no, eventually. So mga factors i-consider natin that can adversely affect your estate plan. Ano yung mga factors na yan? So isang factor is yung saan, no, where your estate plan or will is carried out. So for those of you guys na ano to, na for example holding mga dual citizenship, no, or if you're holding a foreign citizenship, you have properties in various areas, you have to consider also, no, yung impact on that. Saan yung location ng heirs mo at saka yung property, ano yung nationality mo at saka yung heirs mo. Sino yung mag-administer or mag-execute ng estate mo? Yung tawag nila dyan, administrator or executor. The nature of your assets. Then the personality and needs of your heirs. Magkaiba yan, no? Some na mga, siguro mga anak natin, hindi ganun ka interested, no? Because they're also success stories in their own right. But yung ibang anak naman natin, hindi ganun, no? Na successful. Then you have also to consider yung mga in-laws at saka mga creditors and other factors. Now, yung first three, siyempre, for example, if you, ano to, if that's a example yung if you're an American. Example lang, no? Baka yung iba sa inyo hindi Pinoy yung ano to citizenship. If you own a Philippine condo, you will be taxed both by the Philippines and the US. So yun yung epekto niyan, although during your lifetime beneficial yung dual citizenship, then you may be hit by double taxation and that really reduces your estate. Okay, so yun yung mga titingnan natin. O baka pwede mo namang iplano before your death, you maintain one ano to citizenship. Dahil yung epekto niyan yung incidence ng taxation will be very high, walang maiiwan sa ano to mga heirs mo. Of course, another factor, no, yung kinukonsider ng gumagawa ng mga ano to, yung mga last will and testament, yung person that you will appoint as your administrator or executor. Because these are positions of trust and competence. So dapat sigurado tayo na they will implement your wishes. So normally, yung trusted na lawyer natin, no, matagal natin kilala, mataas yung integridad, na we're confident na he or she will implement yung wishes natin. Another factor is yung nature of your assets, no? Yung iba-ibang bansa, they have a lot of restrictions on property and stocks, no? But less restrictions if you hold cash. So isang factor 'yon. So pwede mong i-liquify siguro if you want, no? Yung assets mo, certain ano to, portion of your assets you liquify that into cash. For flexibility. Of course, in the Philippines, you need BIR clearance to transfer real estate and stocks, no? So, pagdating naman sa cash, wala na namang clearance yan, no? Hindi naman, you need, ano to, you don't need BIR clearance, especially if you, ano to, set up yung mga tinatawag nating trust. So, you also have to consider yung, ano to, yung personality ng mga heirs natin. Yung mga heirs natin, some of them, if not all of them, will follow you, your wishes. But you have a lot of stories of heirs challenging your wish. Hindi ka naman, you don't have the ano to, the opportunity to contest yung challenge nila because you're ano to, you're already dead. So this can cause a lot of ano to, emotional at saka financial grief. So you have a lot of stories of heirs, nephews and nieces fighting it out over yung ano to, yung property na hindi naman nila pinaghirapan. And very important sa estate planning is yung ano to, yung you have to analyze, no, yung look at what makes your up your assets. Saan sa located? Do you have complete documents? How are they currently being administered? And all the permits and taxes on them paid. So parang simple lang to na advice, but ito marami nagkakalat dito, no? Because as I mentioned, I have a client na he has built over yung lifetime niya a lot of yung properties. Then siguro yun nga yung during yung ano to, during sa his ano to, yung deathbed, yung wife nag-instruct sa wife kung sino may utang, no? Sino yung sisingilin? Okay, so dapat hindi ganun, no? So if we're really planning for our ano to, yung debt natin, no? No matter how morbid man yan, then we have to make an inventory of all our property. No, kung may mga problema, yung tinatawag nating cloud, no, on real estate, then we have to hire lawyers to ano to, to clear those clouds. So I have also clients na ganyan, iniwan yung problema sa mga anak, yung mga anak naman, yung iba na really well off. At yung iba naman, ano to, yung kaya, so it created a lot of problem among sa mga anak. And if you have the ano to, the resources, then might as well, during your lifetime, pay all real estate taxes. Now also, part of yung estate planning, yung mga obligations natin, yung mga kautangan natin, no, dapat nakalista yan, yung mga original documents, mga resibo. So dapat if you have ano to, yung secured na mga bonds, dapat nakalagay diyan. You may wish to rent out, no, yung ano to, yung mga safety deposit boxes, because a lot of stories yung mga nagpapahinga na naghahanapan pa ng mga dokumento yung mga surviving heirs. Sabi natin, hindi naman natin problema yan kasi anyway yung property papunta sa kanila, but sometimes that will create a lot of issues, no, and trouble sa mga ano to, successors natin. Then one factor sa ano to, yung estate planning is yung how we educate our ano to, yung mga anak natin, yung mga heirs natin, no? So ano yung mga we should relate to them, our expectations, anong gusto natin in order to prevent them from fighting each other. So dapat ano to, we communicate to them yung wishes natin so that early on they can ano to, they can more or less, no, avoid yung possibility of yung quarreling over your estate. So that will be very ano to, embarrassing. So yung rundown natin, no, just quick lang, no, quick because we have very limited time. Yung Filipino the law, no, determines sino yung heirs natin. Hindi tayo pwedeng basta-basta magsabi ibigay natin sa ganyan, ganito ganyan, no, because yung succession is governed, no, by yung Philippine laws. Pagkatapos yung proportion ng estate, kung ano yung ma-receive, sa batas pa rin yan, no. So the only way that we can disinherit yung heir natin is through a court case. Yung proportion ng heirs ano to na matanggap niya cannot be changed. No, so if an heir passes away before you, then you have yung possibility of yung tinatawag nating right of representation. So yung mga anak niya, in which case baka yung mga apo natin. Okay, so we should be aware also yung mga illegitimate children are also heirs. Yung mga anak sa labas, lumalabas yan, no? Pagkamatay ng isang tao. And even if you create a will, you can only dispose of the so-called free portion. So we also should be aware that wills require a court process called probate that validates the will. Tapos yung mga fastest case natin will take sometimes more than a year. Okay, so ang bottom line, the law determines your heirs and the amount that they receive. You cannot change these mandatory heirs. Yung tinatawag natin mga compulsory heirs or the proportion that they will receive, although you may dispose of a free portion through a will. Then yung taxes natin ngayon, no, 6% na, no, on the net estate, effective January 1, 2018 because of the Trin Law. Dati kasi graduated, masyadong mataas. No, net estate, it's gross estate less estate obligations. Okay, so yung gross estate natin is not necessary all the assets of the deceased. For instance, hindi kasama dyan yung mga accruals from the SSS and an irrevocable life insurance policies. Okay, you have estate obligations or claims against the estate, such as loans, mortgages, etc. Now, under yung sakwa natin, Trin Law natin, may standard deduction na tayo na 5 million. Then medyo malaki-laki na yung family home natin because the deduction will be up to 10 million. Okay, so kung malaki-laki na rin pang setup natin, then your target is really to reduce your gross estate or increase the estate obligation to reduce the estate tax. A lot of calculations na to can be done by your trusted accountant. Okay, may question also, ano pong pinakamaganda? Ibenta mo, ibigay mo, no, i-donate mo. Ngayon, practically, wala nang difference because of the yung same na rate na 6%. No, uniform na siya. Kasi dati, mas malaki yung rate ng ano to, estate tax at saka donation when you go to the higher level. So ngayon wala na siyang difference. So yung mga tax avoidance medyo minimize na rin. Then one siguro factor na pwede nating i-consider is yung one person corporation. You want some control even after your death, you create a one person corporation. Okay? If you're an individual, then you may decide to maintain muna yung ano to, sole, no, proprietorship because of the ano to, yung fixed 8% na tax. If your annual revenue is less than 3 million. More than that, sabi ng mga tax experts natin, then you may consider to convert into a corporation. No? Isang bagong innovation ngayon sa corporation code natin is yung one-person corporation. Okay, so you can transfer your property to that one-person corporation tax-free because it's a controlled corporation. So that's one way also for you, especially for those of you suffering from marital ano to, disharmony. May problema na hihingi ka ng mga ano to, yung marital consent. In transferring your assets to one person corporation, you decide, no, solely on your property during your lifetime. Okay, in summary, in summary, because of very limited time natin, you have to set your goals, you have to understand factors that can affect your estate, you have to understand yung Philippine at saka foreign laws, you may need experts, lawyers, accountants to assist you, yung mga trusted na mga professionals. Of course, kanina we mentioned yung you have to account individually your estates, assets, as well as yung liabilities. Then, we mentioned kanina yung need to educate your heirs. Then, operationalize your estate plan and maintain your estate plan. Sabi nga nila, if there are changes, bagong anak or mga bagong negosyo, then you have to review yung estate plan natin. Sabi nga nila, remember that an estate isn't just about pieces of property or paper. No, an estate is tied to people and families. Now, often, estate planning becomes sensitive when emotions are involved. One child might feel excluded. Another child might remember a slight from childhood that has never quite gone away. Managing emotions and expectations are very important and have to be handled with tact. So, also remember that estates only work when you are absolutely upfront with your estate advisor. So, sino yung mga trusted natin ng mga estate advisors, we should also disclose yung full facts at saka yung gusto natin para they can navigate well yung estate planning. An estate plan should be considered an important part of planning for the future. Much like saving for your children's college education or upcoming medical expenses. At the end of the day, the best estate plan serves you and your family. With that, siguro, very short presentation. I hope I triggered a lot of your imaginations and for you to plan well your estate. Thank you very much for listening to my presentation.
Thank you, Attorney Ray. So now the floor is now open for your questions. So just chat in our chat box, or you can unmute yourself to ask Attorney Ray for your question. So actually, we have 15 questions in the Facebook Live. So we're very grateful and thank you for all the audience watching our Facebook Live about the topic of Attorney Ray. So maybe I can start one of the questions in the FB Live. So there's one question, Attorney Ray, from AC Temenya. Hi, Attorney Ray. Are there any government agency that actually help people who have mental problems?
Mukhang yung topic ata sa kabila yan, Jomar. But siguro, we have the National Mental Health yung hospital natin sa Mandaluyong
correct.
We can refer.
Yeah, okay. So we have to move on because you're speaking about you.
Here, Jomar, nasa chat po, Jomar. Nasa chat box po. We have from chat box.
Okay. From Win Plaza, Attorney Ray, what happens if an illegitimate child shows up after the properties or asset have been distributed? Is there a chance that a relocation may happen?
Yes, no, may recourse pa yung illegitimate child. Alam naman natin, no, yung under succession, an illegitimate child should receive one half of the share of the legitimate child. So baka may gagawin appellation, no, accounting, so that those who have received yung advance shares nila can contribute, no, sa share ng yung kapatid nila na anak sa labas.
Okay, thank you, Attorney Ray. So we move to the second question from our JCI Senator Jose Lito Pupum. Filipinos are poor on estate planning. This leads to improper use of resources, poor investments, legal cases between families and relatives. Is this now taught in our colleges for all courses? This is a must even before you start working for a job. This explains why Filipinos are not keen on insurances early on, only to scramble to buy one late in the day. What do you suggest to swing the tide of our Filipino workers, professionals to exercise estate planning early before it's too late?
Yeah, one factor siguro, Jomari, nakita ko cultural, no? It's something na parang hindi comfortable lahat na you talk of yung planning for your debt. Especially for parents. Dapat kasi nauna dyan yung parents, hindi yung mga anak. Kasi kung anak naman magsasabi, sabihin ng parents, buhay pa naman kami. So parang alien sa atin na ano to, na yung something na iplano natin. Especially, siguro, except for the higher, ano to, no? Higher echelons ng society natin, it's something na parang hindi comfortable yung mga Pinoy na pinag-uusapan yung kamatayan. So, I agree, kailangan din sigurong part ng ano to, curriculum yan, no? So, one thing sa mga courses, yung mga teachers, professors like me, no? We'll have to really insert yung topic ng estate planning sa ano to, sa mga subjects.
Okay, thank you. Hope that it was answered by Attorney Senator Joselito Ocon. So we have to see the next question from Asuncion Martinez. Attorney Ray, how expensive is judicial settlement of estate? If the heirs refuses to go extrajudicial settlement of estate?
Yeah, yung pinakamaganda talaga extrajudicial settlement, no? Kasi kasunduan lang, nag-agree. So, wala masyadong problema. When they go judicial, no, disputed na, both parties will have to shell out on legal fees, no, aside from yung filing fees. Pagkatapos yung a factor pa na winner take all, or even na panalo yung both parties will have to pay at attorney's fees. So, malaking bayad sa mga abogado, no, because yung full-blown na trial or litigation, lawyers get on the average, 20-30% of the recovery. No? So just imagine 20-30%. Kung pag-usapan na lang yan, para wala na yung babayad sa mga abogado and you maintain yung relationship better. No? Go for extrajudicial. No? Or siguro, kung hindi magkasundo, find a third person na pwedeng magpagitna para magbigayan yung mga parties.
Okay, thank you for that answer, Attorney Ray. So we go to the next question from Maria Elsa Casaneda. Attorney Ray, what happens if the property being owned is still in the process of or for titling? Can that be included in the list of the estate ownership?
Yes, pwede pa siya, no? Yung ano to, that can be collated, no? Pag-uusapan ko ano yung problema ng property na yan, kung may mga obligations, that can be accounted. So, ang importante, lahat ng mga properties na own or merong claim yung estate, dapat isama doon sa ano to, sa settlement ng estate ng namatay.
Okay, so thank you, Attorney Ray. So, any questions from this room? We can get another two before we end this session. Oh, wait, there's another question from the chat room. Okay, from NC Josephine Lorca. Attorney, my brother suddenly passed away. Di na sign ang will. What to do?
Ako, yung will dapat pirmado, no? You have two types of wills kasi yung notarial. No, then following formalities ng batas, no, may mga witnesses, then you have yung holographic. So dapat pirmado. Kung hindi pirmado, then ang masusunod yung ano to, ordinary rules on succession.
Okay, thank you. So maraming questions.
Joms, may mag may nag-unmute. Hello, sir. Sir Ray, may nag-unmute po.
Sige po.
Unmute lang po. Would like to ask.
Antonio Ray po, Bautista. Yes, sir. Does
an estate plan have to be written, handwritten, or you can type it?
Okay, sir. Yung estate plan kasi totality ng ano to, yung approach ng namatay, eh, no? So definitely it involves ano to, yung mga real estate, yung requirement ng public instrument kasama na dyan, at saka ano yung type of yung contract na gagawin. It can be donation, no, it can be ano to, yung transfer in exchange of shares of stock. So depende po yan sa kuan, depende po sa final na ano to, yung approach, no, yung strategy ng advisor. So kailangan din i-customize sa requirements ng ano to, yung client, kung ano yung gusto niya, no, because may mga considerations, no, ito ang plano niya ibigay sa isang anak niya, yung negosyos sa isang anak niya, yung iba naman property, yung ibang pera, no, so everything may mga kanya-kanyang mga formalities, no, may mga kanya-kanyang mga documentation na required under the law.
May question, thank you Attorney Ray. May question, Joms, dito sa ano, sa Facebook Live. I'll read na lang, ha.
Sige po.
Attorney Ray, my father, a former department head, died last 2018. He left us a handful of properties like hectares of land. Sir, how can we siblings avoid conflict in sharing the properties he left us? Could we seek a lawyer advice or settlement for the matter? So I assume wala silang will.
Yeah, ang suggestion ko, huli muna si attorney, no, yung lawyer. Sila muna mag-uusap as magkakapatid. Paano nila paghatiin yung property, no? They have to account for everything, search ng mga other properties na baka hindi na nakita. And after ano to, after na makita tong mga properties na to, no, they have an idea paano yung distribution, yung hatian. And after they have siguro yung idea, then that will be the time that they'll be consulting a lawyer on how to operationalize yung ano to, yung distribution. Kasi yung mga ibang properties baka ano to, no, iba-iba yung stages of ano to, yung level of yung ownership.
Okay, so thank you Attorney Ray. So Attorney Ray, meron pa tayo question. We'll accept this one sa chat box. We have 4 remaining questions. So from MVP Henry, if the person died single, his or her property, saan ba pupunta?
Okay, yung just yung general background ng succession. Ang laws on succession, pababa palagi. No? Pababa palagi. Kung walang ano to, heir sa baba, ibig sabihin walang anak, paket naman siya. No? Kung wala sa taas, then pagilid siya. Now, mauwi talaga na kung wala talagang ano to, wala talagang heirs, pauwi sa gobyerno. Yun yung tinatawag nating escheat. No? So eventually, yung kaya kung may mga asset ka man, kung wala ka mang heirs, better you transfer it to foundation, no, or social causes na gusto mo, kasi you'll be honored kahit na papano. No, rather than ano to, yung all your estate will go to government.
Okay, thank you, Attorney. We go to the question of MVP ND Ismael Penado. Is a family corporation binding among the heirs or family constitution, I mean?
Yeah, isang maganda din yan, no? Importante na well-crafted yung ano to, family corporation. Ano yung mga restrictions? Kasi most family corporations, they set that up as parang closed corporation. No, walang basta-basta makapasok, di ba? Makapasok under certain conditions. So as long as crafted yon in such a way, no, yung articles sa kabylos, no, that will be ano to, that will be kung wala namang wala namang yung provisions do not violate yung mga batas natin, that family corporation, no, a setup will govern, no, yung behavior ng lahat ng mga heirs.
Okay, thank you. We have to accept this last 3 question from attorney Alexander Sonsa. What happened when a compulsory heirs ay hindi sinama sa last will or a testament?
Yeah, so hindi nakasama siya, so pwede siyang humabol. No, di ba, kung sa yung mga property even covered by yung extrajudicial settlement, you have parang rule 74 section 4 yan,
yeah,
na for 2 years may claim pa, so pwede pa siyang humabol, no, pwede pa siyang humabol just in case na hindi nasama. So even assuming na lumampas na, no, under the ano to, under the hands of very skillful na lawyer, pwede pa siyang humabol pa rin, no, just in case na he was intentionally excluded, no, by the decedent or even yung mga co-heirs niya.
Okay, thank you, attorney, no. So talagang I think there's another question from I will accept the two questions. Then hopefully, some of the questions we will answer. We will ask Attorney Ray to answer, and we will send the answer about your question. So from Asuncion Martinez, if this holographic will and not notarized, that it needs to be probated?
Pwede mong i-ano to, no? Kailangan i-probate siya. No, ang requirement kasi ng probate to ensure na ano to, no? Valid ano to, yung formalities. Na yung pirma talaga, pirma ng ano to, decedent 'yan. No, so yung formal requirements, ma-check talaga kung kasi kung holographic 'yan, it should be written, dated, and signed, no, in the name of the decedent. So ipo-prove 'yan, no, yung tinatawag nating probate proceedings, to ensure na hindi fraud yan o, di ba, falsified yung holographic will. Once na probated, yung contents mismo, implement ng kwan na yan. Implement ng executor or administrator.
Okay, thank you, attorney. Last one question from Maria Elsa Casaneda. Attorney Ray, an uncle died ahead of his wife, but the siblings found out that the wife donated the properties to only one. How can it be contested?
Ano yung, can you repeat, Jo Marie? Ano yung, I did not get yung ginawa ng wife eh.
An uncle died ahead of his wife, but the siblings found out that the wife donated the properties to only one person. How can it be contested?
Yes, meron tayong tinatawag na ano to, yung in case, for example, yung donation na prejudicial to the other heirs. No, intentionally done para to prejudice yung the other heirs, then in that case pwedeng habulin pa ng mga heirs na excluded, especially yung intention talaga is really to exclude them dun sa share, dun sa estate. Kung sobra-sobra ding donation, no, yung tinatawag nating inofficious donations, pwedeng i-reduce din yan, but you have to take legal action. No, yun yung disadvantage, and you, of course you will incur ano to, yung legal expenses in the process.
Okay, I think I have to accept na lang to, yung boss ko, si NBP Henry. If the person died, he just make a handwritten last will and testament on how to distribute his estate. Question, is the will that he write in his own handwritten valid even hindi na notarized?
Yes, yung holographic kasi hindi kailangan na notarize yan. No? But dadaan ng probate proceedings. And sometimes ang dami ng contest doon, no? Sabihin nila baka ano to, the decedent was unduly influenced, no, hindi yun yung intention niya. But kung gusto talagang i-submit ng ano to yung mga heirs, no, kasi they cannot ano to, they cannot receive yung property, then dadaan talaga ng probate proceedings, no. The probate court will ensure na hindi fraudulent yung holographic will. Now if there's an order na ano to, okay na, regular yung ano to probate, then doon pa lang natin ano to implement yung ano to, yung tinatawag na yung mga testamentary dispositions. Ano yung content ng holographic will?
Okay. So thank you. Thank you very much to our resource speaker, Attorney Ray Cartujano, for a very enlightening presentation and for answering all the questions. I know there is so many questions in the Facebook Live, but we will do our best to send to Attorney Ray to answer all that question.
Yeah.
So may I now call on
more than 30 questions of Facebook Live actually.
Attorney Coach Len.
I hope meron kayong natutunan na sa presentation ko.
Okay.
For those of you
okay, this certificate
this,
of appreciation is awarded
YouTube,
to Attorney Ray D. Cartujano
presentation
for sharing his knowledge on estate planning for Filipinos during this pandemic, during the virtual 53rd anniversary of JCI Senate Philippines. Given this 25th of September 2021, signed Senator Mijoyce Galanto, our chairperson, signed by Senator Fulbert Wu, our chapter president, and signed by our national president, Gregorio Lipa.
Thank you for listening, guys. Watching this YouTube na
so thank you again, and we have